Hi, I'm Kressel Anderson. This is Makercise. In this episode, I'll be completing the most requested upgrade to the lathe. I'm installing a chuck.
So my plan is to ultimately have the chuck mounted to a steel chuck adapter that is threaded onto a permanent spindle. However, I'll go into why I'm not doing that initially a little bit later in the video. Initially, I'm going to cast an aluminum plate that will serve as an adapter between the chuck and my faceplate. That way I can just bolt the whole assembly onto my faceplate and turn parts that way. I made a foam pattern similar to the way I've done in previous videos, and I put on plaster of Paris refractory coating, embedded it into a flask with sand using my vibratory table. And then I took it over to my mobile sand cart for casting. Melted the aluminum and poured it.
Okay.
Does that matter?
What's that?
Is there a brick on the bottom?
Thank you. I made a new pattern for this adapter plate for the chuck that I'm going to put on the lathe, because the first one that I made and cast is really too small. After I got it cut up and kind of compared it with the chuck, I decided that the fasteners for mounting this adapter to the faceplate, they need to go on the outside of the chuck. There's just not enough meat because my faceplate has 4 holes and the chuck has 3 mounting holes. To orient that and not have interference, it really just doesn't leave enough meat, I think, for the faceplate. So I've made a slightly larger disc pattern that I'm going to cast in aluminum. It's in the foam, it's in the sand, it's got the refractory coating on it, so I'll be casting that here shortly. After I get this part cast, I'll go ahead and take it over to the lathe. I will bore it, I will face off one side, then I'll probably put it on an arbor to turn the outside and face off the other side of the disc. And after I've got it fastened to the faceplate, I can reduce the little shoulder so that it mates well with the chuck. So then I should have a chuck. Hopefully this will work out. Man, I love lost foam.
As per my usual process, I cut off the sprue and then took the cast part over to the sander for a little bit of cleanup. Once I cleaned up the casting, I laid out the holes that I will drill in the casting, and these holes will allow me to use bolts to secure this part to my faceplate for a little bit of machining. And I'm using those 1-2-3 blocks again. They're tapped on the largest sides, and that makes them easy to secure both to the faceplate and to secure the part to the 1-2-3 blocks. I used a dead center in the tailstock to help me hold this part, you know, roughly in the center while I secured it to the faceplate.
I machined down a little bit of a shoulder so that I can register this adapter plate with this new kind of modified adapter plate, and that will allow me to match drill the holes that will mate with the chuck onto this new adapter plate. I'm going to go ahead and transfer the adapter plate that I've started turning, that I've bored out and got the register turned into, onto this arbor. It's one of the shafts that I turned as a permanent shaft that ended up kind of not ever getting used, but it does have a 5/8 inch portion of this shaft, so I'm going to use that, and then I'm going to face off both sides, turn the outside diameter, and then I'll transfer those holes, drill the holes, and I'll have to flip it around, mount it on the faceplate, and then I can neck down a little register and actually mount the chuck to this adapter plate that will bolt onto this faceplate, and then I can start making other parts until I get my permanent spindle, which will use this steel adapter plate for the chuck. And now I'm going to flip the part around so I don't have to move my tool post to the other side of the compound.
Earlier, I used super glue to attach this part to the turning arbor. And now that I'm done with the operations I needed to do while it's on the arbor, I use my little propane torch just to heat up the part and the arbor until the super glue breaks down and I can just wiggle it loose. The turning operation, because of the radius of my tool, left a little bit of a ridge around the inside of the part, and I just knocked that down with the scraper. I took the temporary adapter over to the faceplate, tested the fit, then it's on to drilling the holes in the temporary adapter. I used the off-the-shelf chuck adapter plate to locate these holes in the temporary chuck adapter plate, and that way I can make sure that the spacing is about right. I don't have like an indexer or anything that would help me make 120 degree spaced holes of the right radius to attach the chuck to the adapter plate. So that's why I use this off-the-shelf part to help me place the holes in this temporary adapter plate. I used a spade bit to drill a little bit of a relief on the back side of this adapter plate. This is the side that goes up against the faceplate, and because of the hardware that I had in stock, it was basically just hex head bolts, I needed a little bit of clearance for those heads on the back. And that way, you know, the adapter plate can still mount flush to the faceplate. I laid out some additional holes because those bigger holes that I used to hold it for the initial machining operations against the faceplate are not what I ultimately want to be using to secure this adapter to the faceplate. So I drilled new holes and I tapped them for fasteners, and that way these fasteners can come in from the back side of the faceplate and secure this adapter plate to the faceplate. Now that it's installed onto the faceplate, I can turn down the little shoulder that sticks in the back of the chuck and keeps it registered with the axis of rotation of the lathe. It turns out that that little recess is about 55 millimeters in diameter, so that's what I turn down this little shoulder on this adapter plate. I test the fit and I was pretty happy, pretty pleased with how that turned out. With the chuck registration shoulder turned onto this adapter plate, I went ahead and removed it from the faceplate and took it over to my tool cart to install the fasteners and actually attach this chuck to its adapter plate so that I could install it back on the faceplate and get started turning some parts. One last thing I decided to do was check the runout of the chuck, and I checked it right up against that adapter plate, and it does have a little bit of runout.
I'm really happy to have this chuck installed, and just that little test I did with that hex coupler, oh man, I'm gonna have so much better efficiency getting parts chucked up and turned, and repeatably having them roughly centered. There's a little bit of runout on this temporary plate. Hopefully when I get the permanent spindle installed, that will help everything come together and have a little lower runout. But even with that runout, this is so much of an improvement over those angle clamps that I've been using. So really happy about it. Special thanks to the sponsor of today's video, which are the cadre level patrons. David, Matthew, Bob, you guys are great, and you guys are one of the big reasons why this stuff keeps happening. I really appreciate your support, and in particular, Bob, I really appreciate you sending me these parts, the chuck, for this project. That is super cool that you're wanting to invest your time to turn a part, your money to buy a chuck and send it to me. I really appreciate that. That is so cool, man. Bob turned this spindle for me. He turned it to the dimensions in the Gingery books. You know, it's got a 3/4 inch threaded end on it. It's got the 3/4 inch bearing surface for the right side of the headstock, as well as the 5/8 inch shaft for where the pulleys. It would be a drop-in replacement, but those bearings that I've got in here are actually kind of worn, so I'm gonna need to turn replacement bearings. Enter the chuck and the ability to quickly turn down bronze bushings for this improved spindle. So I'm pretty excited about it, and hopefully it'll help me get a lot more mileage out of this lathe. I hope this project builds your confidence to exercise your inner maker. If you like the video, click the like button. And if you really like the project, consider subscribing. Thanks for watching.
Wow, messiest ever.